Right. Well, the first thing that I wanted to say before I open the magic bag and show you these innovative products that have come through my connections with Mintel, and there's the advert, Mintel and the GMPD system. They are collecting innovations from all over the world every day to the tune, in fact we were told yesterday, because at the moment, and we have them all in the audience here, there are a number of people from Michigan State University, and we had a presentation from Mintel yesterday, and they are collecting 1,000 a day, apparently now. They have a huge staff of people there who are collecting this information and putting it into the database. The database has over 2 million different items of packaging in it, which are obviously searchable to whatever anyone wants. So that's where most of these have come from, and I will talk about those in a minute. But what I wanted to say to set the scene, I have my own opinion on primary arenas in packaging. You may have different ideas. My main contention is communications. That affects us all. It is diabolical in places, it's very good in other places. We must always think about it. Secondly is the management of knowledge. There is so much knowledge there. It was mentioned just now, yourself who spoke about this wonderful new device that has been brought out by Crown that will easily open these containers. And it works. And the interesting thing, and I don't know whether you've noticed this, but when you close it, it causes a partial vacuum as well, which is quite interesting. So there may be an element there of letting the life of that jam be a bit longer before the mould grows on it, which can so often happen, unless you've got loads of kids. The third item on my list is environmental affairs, whether it be sustainability, carbon footprint. I'm not going to go into any of this because we could spend all evening on it. And the fourth item, as ever, is innovations, innovations, innovations. You heard what Mark said. Every company is trying to do the same thing. We all want to see innovations, new ways of presenting things, new systems. So, without any ado, let me show you what some other countries have done in terms of innovation. And of course, innovation can come in many different ways. You may or may not have seen that. That is for water. Comes from Scandinavia. Most intriguing and peculiar design. Needless to say, any of you would say, how the hell do you stack that on a shelf? Well, you don't. They put it in a dump bin, apparently, over there. And the reason they did it this way is that when you get so many of them and so many tags, you can send off to the head office and they will give you connectors so that these will connect with each other in a Lego-like system, so that the kids can then build things and so on. So, clever idea. It doesn't seem to have gone any farther than Scandinavia. I will put all these down if anyone wants to see them later. They are welcome. I'm just picking everything at random, so you don't know what you're going to get next. This company, Davidoff. You've all heard of Davidoff. Aftershave, perfumes, all these kinds of things. Who would have expected Davidoff to produce, he said, hoping he can get the chopper. Damn packaging. Can't even get the chopper. What?
It's a temporary one.
Yeah, the easy open pack.
It's an all pack.
I opened it yesterday.
It's all to do with the age. It's age.
Oh, the top was already off. That's why I couldn't get it off. So, we have this fantastic pack from Davidoff, which is in a metal canister. God, I can see why consumers don't like these things. For coffee. Now, who would have expected Davidoff to produce coffee? They've done it. I've not tried the coffee yet, but it tells you on there it's absolutely fabulous. Who knows? But they produced a coffee pack. Totally different to anyone else's. The price of that is probably way over the top, but then you pay over the top for Davidoff or any of the luxury aftershaves anyway. So this shows where not only are they producing an innovative pack, but they're being innovative in their marketing and coming out with new ideas. and I shall curse that, the fact that that didn't come off. Right, put that one there. Still, it adds to the humour of the evening. Now, this one I want to show you because it is so simple, any of you would pick that up and say, well, so what? It's just a tubular bottle. There's nothing to that. It's for burn and bite. So if you've been bitten by mosquitoes or whatever, you put this gel on and I assume it will solve all your problems. Normally, you would expect things like this to be in a flexible tube. That's where most of these things come. So you think, well, why have they done that? And what's the advantage? Where do we go? To start with, that's going to cost you less than a flexible tube. But you immediately think, well, flexible tube, you squeeze it out. What these people have done, which is absolutely brilliant, and this is where I bring in the context of machinery and the applications of machines within the world of packaging that we know. When you blow a bottle and you produce the parison that comes down to give you that bottle, whatever size it is, they have a system on there of control using computer-driven analysis and so on that ensures that the wall thickness is equal all the way round, which used to be a problem years gone by before they had these. So all your bottles, in theory, should be equal wall thickness. Wonderful. These guys have been very clever and said, we want a squeezable bottle, so we make the wall a bit thinner on one side so you can squeeze it. And that's precisely what they've done. So they've altered the method that normally you would make a bottle to make it squeezable. And that is absolutely brilliant. And I only hope that a lot of people take that up because it's a very intelligent way of making a squeezable pack.
Which country is that from, Keith?
Which one? That one?
The squeezable.
I'll let you read it. The country will be on there. I can't remember offhand. There's a handy item. What do you reckon came in that?
Hungry.
Absolutely right. There we are. It says what it is as a package, hand cream, which goes to show that one of the design innovations that's coming out, and it is used in many areas, is using mimicry in your packaging. And what's simpler than that? It is easy to handle. I suppose a lady could put that in their handbag quite easily. A bloke could put it in his pocket if blokes use hand cream. I don't particularly, but there we are. It's so simple and probably effective. Hopefully they sell lots of products that way. How are we going about time?
7, 8 minutes.
Right, I'll leave that one to last then. This one I brought for the design people because in looking at the packaging that I get from Mintel, I'm looking at it from the point of view of innovation on the physical side and on the mimicry side and all the areas where we can look at it, as well as the graphics. And I don't know what you think, but I thought the graphics on that were particularly good. It's only a simple, what's this one, tequila. And of course, as you may or may not know, but tequila is being sold more and more. And I guess 12, 15 years ago, it was a speciality drink, but now you can get tequila in many, many different packages. And this one I thought was particularly attractive. It's a black coated bottle and this wonderful silk screen design on it that if that was on a shelf, it would really stand out. And maybe that's what they have to do because tequila's become so popular. To get your brand noticed more than anyone else, you've got to do something like that so that it screams at you. I did have another one that screams at you, but I wasn't bringing it tonight because it's too damned heavy. So I won't even talk about that. So we'll put that there.
Full.
No, sorry. No, it's not full. Why, are you a tequila addict?
Oh, no.
Anything.
Free drink addict.
Now, another thing that's fascinating, and I find that appears, I don't know why, but you get this more in America than you do in the UK, although there are shops opening up in the UK for what I call the fun side of packaging for kids. And this is the latest, and it really struck me as quite funny. It's connected to The Penguins of Madagascar, which I understand is a kiddies type film, and I don't quite know why, but this to me, I think, is supposed to be a lemur from Madagascar because of the tail, and I've no idea whether a lemur makes that noise, but they've made it to make a noise. And I guess the kiddies will say, gee mum, we've got to have one of them. So these are the kind of peculiar things that you get for kiddies. The sweeties, which is the main idea of selling it, there's a few in there. But I guess the kids love that. So it's another innovative thing, thinking about the children's market and how you can persuade them to produce packaging. This one I love. Again, this is using packaging technology. This is a lip salve, and the clever piece about this, and I'm deliberately holding it away from you at the moment, it's in a blister pack, just a simple blister pack, with a card backing and the actual lip salve in a part of the blister. And the top of the blister has been shaped like a lip, and it is also printed like a lip and stands out in 3D because of the magnifying attitude of the plastic, which is really clever the way a designer has utilised that in a very simple way, a very cost-effective pack, and really striking. Someone thinking outside the box, obviously. Could be used in many different areas. I've not seen it in any other areas like that, so the world is your oyster. Right. I'll forget that one, Luke. What else we got? Oh, following on the theme of shapes, this is an interesting pack for lemon juice, shaped like a slice of lemon, which is quite clever. So it shows you what is in the package. You don't even have to think. That is lemon. Don't have to worry. Don't have to read the language. Whatever's on there, and I can't recall. So there's yet another interesting package. But I'm not going to show you everything. Oh yeah, just to introduce the world of pharmaceuticals, you may have seen it. I've seen this before when it was a prototype. This one happens to be Sanofi Aventis, and as you may or may not know, within the world of pharmaceuticals, they're all joining up with each other. It's the only way that you can keep going in our peculiar packaging marketplace. This is an interesting pack in that as soon as you pull, as it says there, you straight away get your pills and your information. An expensive pack, but nevertheless, it's different. I hope it will sell. It's difficult with pharmaceuticals because they've got to sell because the doctor told you you're going to have that, so you technically got a closed market. But very interesting pack, could be used in many areas. First came out probably 7-8 years ago. Not been used as much as I think it should be. Very innovative. And I will come to the final item for you. He's laughing already because he knows what's coming. As long as I can read it. This is the mundane water package. And this one's from China. The ever faithful China. Wonderful bottle. Well, simple bottle. PET. Nothing common or, something very common about it because it's dead simple. It's cheap. It's like any other water bottle. And then they put it in this laminate material. So they've immediately increased the cost tremendously, and you think, what the hell have they done that for? I will tell you. Or at least I'll read to you what they say. You can believe it or not. Find the right one. It's all there somewhere. Right. In order to prevent contamination and effect of direct contact with light and electromagnetic radiation, which will change the structure and energy level of the pre-ecological glacier water, we have introduced a new outer packaging which seals off light and electromagnetic waves that will affect water quality to ensure consumers are able to consume the 9,610-year-old pre-ecological glacier water in its original taste and quality. Now, how's that for a bit of marketing bluff? If there's anyone here who knows anything about the electromagnetic radiation of water, I'd be delighted to hear from you. But with that comment, I will close my short history of some of the weird and wonderful items of innovative packaging that are around in the world at the moment. There are thousands of others.